Hi guys, Mark here. We've got the eXp 7000 in the VLF configuration. We've got the VLF coil, and we're going to show you how to run a VLF ground scan and to use the VLF coil together with the control panel. It's a really fun system. Let's go see how it's done. So here we have the controller. It's already turned on, powered up, and because we have the VLF coil attached to it, we have the two functions that are available in the eXp 7000 with the VLF coil. The VLF metal detection, which is your standard sweeping motion that everyone who's used a VLF coil has done before. And we've got the brand new VLF ground scan. So what we're going to do with this is we're going to cover this area and see what type of targets we have in this area with the VLF scan. Okay, we're going to do a VLF ground scan now, and I'll walk you through the process here. So we've got the pentacoil attached. We've got parallel, automatic. The speaker is on. We go to the next step, and we're going to leave it on so it identifies all of the potential metals shown. The next step is the ground balance. So we hold it over the ground. We press the check mark. The ground balance is done. I press the play button and we're scanning. Now we go back to the start and we've got line two. We go back to the start, and now we do line three. Okay, so we finished the VLF ground scan. You see we've got several targets here. Let's go to save. And we've got 13 feet. We can test this. And 13 feet. And now, you can see from this, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 potential targets. That may be two targets, I'm not sure. We'll have to look at it and see. But what it gives you is basically a complete ground scan of this area, and it shows you the potential targets. Not only the potential targets, but it also shows you the potential metal that is in those targets represent. So it's a step above your typical VLF ground or VLF scan. You've got the ability here with this to say, okay, these are where the objects are, and go in and decide whether you want to dig them up. I know for a lot of archaeologists or people working in an area where there may be some archaeological finds are of importance, you can't just dig these up. So in cases like that, this is the perfect format to identify what is potentially in the ground to determine what the next step in the process is.